Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the A-Side. I am your host, Riley, and today I will be ranking every studio album by Las Vegas indie rock band The Killers from worst to best. I say studio albums because I will not be including the 2007 compilation album Sawdust. Long story short, it's okay. Now, The Killers is a band I have a long history with. They were a band that was highly influential in the development of my music taste. I do have a weird relationship with The Killers, though, because I don't know if there's a band I love this much that I also have this much beef with. This band's quality has not been consistent, to say the least. So naturally, I have a lot to say. Buckle in, because this will probably be a long one. But before we get started, make sure you hit that subscribe button. It's free, and you can always unsubscribe later if you want. Now, without further ado, let's get into number 7.
Parking lot is rent, the shotgun pickup trucks.
In last place, we have The Killers' newest album, Pressure Machine. The Killers' kind of country record. They're trying way too hard with the small town in the heartland of America stuff. It's to the point where it becomes like a caricature of itself. Lyrics like, "The parking lot is rammed with shotgun pickup trucks at the Jones rubber plant, where all the guys end up beer-drinking Boy Scouts living life they ain't stuck." As someone who lives in a small town, it just annoys me to hear that kind of stuff, who lives around this kind of stuff all the time. They make it sound so romantic and great. Living in a small town is not fun. Being a small town country boy is not what it's cracked up to be. Most of those people are pretty obnoxious. And the small town idea worked on Sam's Town because it was a frame of reference to talk about things much deeper, more personal and emotional than that, just the "we're in a small town." And The Killers have never been able to pull this off again. Brandon's vocals have become so one-dimensional and predictable. But the biggest problem with this album is just how slow and boring it is. This record drags. The interviews interwoven between tracks just make it drag even worse. This was actually such a problem. It was so bad that they actually had to release an abridged version of the record.
Miss Atomic Bomb, making out, we got the radio on.
At number 6, Battleborn. You know, I used to hate this album. I still do. On Battleborn, The Killers lose all sense of identity of who they are. Brandon Flowers is so up his own ass with the Heartland, small town America bullshit. I just hate it. And this is a problem that will persist throughout the rest of their discography. His lyrics are just obnoxious. And the songs just aren't here. The entire record is made up of some of the most forgettable mid-tempo slogs you will ever hear. Sometimes it even devolves into cringe power ballads comparable to the cheesy 80s hair metal bands like on Here With Me. This album just lacks anything endearing. Even the song names are uninspired. Runaways, Here With Me, Be Still, Heart of a Girl. Every once in a while, there would be like a cool guitar lick or synth line that will catch your ear. You know, "Oh, that's pretty cool." But it's like putting whipped cream on a pile of shit. Like, yeah, whipped cream is great, and it looks more presentable, but it's still a pile of shit at the end of the day, and you don't want to eat that. This record is uninteresting, soul-inspired heartland slock. This doesn't work for The Killers, and still doesn't work. No matter how many attempts they make, it's a far cry from Mr. Brightside. At number 5, we have Wonderful Wonderful. The Killers lost all sense of self on Battleborn, so when they followed it up, they found themselves in complete disarray. This record is an incoherent mess. The first 3 songs are all in completely different styles. The title track is like a movie score, with its, you know, thick bass line, followed up by the braggadocious dance song, The Man, then Rut, which sounds like a Battleborn leftover. It's a really mixed bag quality-wise, too, but it's definitely got its moments. I love the cinematic and epic opener, Wonderful, Wonderful. The Man is an absolute blast and a welcome burst of energy for this era of the Killers. Run for Cover is an absolute banger and probably the closest thing the Killers have come to sounding like Hot Fuss again. Tyson V. Douglas is easily my favorite track on the record, though. It's about how Flowers felt when he saw Champ and his idol, Mike Tyson, go down in the championship boxing match. He saw his hero go down against all odds, and he was so disappointed and felt like his entire world had been shattered. And then he compares that moment to fatherhood and vows never to disappoint his children in the same way. He won't let his children, you know, see him go down and kind of crush their worldview. It's filled with emotion and great vocals from Brandon Flowers. The chorus here is amazing. When I saw him go down, felt like somebody lied. Amazing moment. It's a highlight of the 2010s decade for The Killer. For The Killer, it's probably the highlight. The Calling is alright, too. The rest of the album, though, is mostly pretty boring, bland, and uninspired, as most contemporary Killer's tracks are. Songs like Rut and Some Kind of Love are the audio equivalent of watching paint dry. Out of My Mind feels very cliche with its obvious references. It's only the billionth time a song has referenced Romeo and Juliet and McCartney or things and the like. Wonderful, Wonderful definitely isn't a horrible album, but it's far too inconsistent to be a good one. P.S. bonus track, Money on Straight, should have been on the album. The thing's great. I tried going against my own soul's warning. It's at this point where there is a significant jump in quality on the list, as I think Imploding the Mirage is the best album the Killers have made in over a decade. I mean, where was this inside of them? Now, don't get me wrong. It's not a perfect record. There are moments where lyrically it falls into some of the same pitfalls in the previous record. The biggest culprit of this is the closing track, Imploding the Mirage, with its "I was a timid rock brilliant boy." I mean, kill me. But for the most part, I can ignore this because the songs on this record are just so good. Like, that's the problem with a record like Battleborn, is the songs just aren't there. They are on Imploding the Mirage, apart from the aforementioned closing track and the bold yet failure of an experiment that is When the Dreams Run Dry. I love every song on this record. And I was very worried for Imploding the Mirage after the abysmal single Land of the Free that came out a year or two prior. Luckily, that awful song was cut from the track list, and what we were left with was excellent. The first time I heard this album, I was blown away by opening track My Own Soul's Warning, with its soaring hooks. It's at that moment I knew that the Killers were truly back, and that song became an instant classic for me. Caution gives me a similar feeling with its soaring vocals and synths, along an excellent guitar courtesy of Lindsey Buckingham of Fleetwood Mac. My God has one of the best choruses the band has ever written, at least in a long time. Don't talk to me about forgiveness. My God, just look who's back in business. I love the soundscape that Lightning Field crafts. Running Toward the Place is just cool. And Fire and Bone is a love letter to the alt-rock of the 80s, drawing heavy influence from bands like New Order, The Smiths, The Cure, and most of all, The Talking Heads. It's my favorite on the record. I love the groovy bass line and the jangly chorus, jangly guitars, and the cool 80s retro synths. This album will always take me back to warm August days driving the countryside in a cool air-conditioned car the summer before my senior year. I did do a review on this album when it dropped, so if you want to hear my deeper thoughts on Imploding the Mirage, go check that out. I'm glad we got one last truly great Killers album, even all these years later. Bless your body, bless your soul, pray for peace and self-control. In every ranked video, I have a hot take in the ranking, and this is the one for this video. Day and Age, number 3. This is the Killers' poppiest and most whimsical album in their discography, But this is juxtaposed with the fact that this may be the Killers' darkest album lyrically to date, with running themes of suicide, depression, and hopelessness. I even have my own theories regarding this album being like a concept album about two individuals, one being someone who survived suicide and someone struggling with suicidal thoughts, exchanging a conversation about the way they feel and their experiences. I do plan on one day making a full video talking about this theory and how I interpret this album and like a review of the record, and that will come one day. It just will be way too long to talk about now. Musically, too, I think this album is great. It's got a bit of something for everybody. It's got the poppy hits like Spaceman and Human, which are always a pleasure to listen to. Joyride is extremely danceable with its groovy bass line. Not your style? Try the somber and atmospheric Goodnight Travel Well. How about the excellent opener, Losing Touch? My personal favorite is the musical smorgasbord, I Can't Stay, including strings, saxophone, and Jamaican steel drums, along with some of Brandon's most beautiful vocals. This is a record I love dearly. Whimsical and eclectic with hard-hitting lyrics. There's also great bonus tracks. Forget About What I Said is so good, and it now feels like the end of the classic Killers era. I will defend Day and Age as amazing until the end. It feels so weird putting Hot Fuss at only number 2. It's an amazing album. I'd argue even a flawless one. It's also an album that's particularly important to me. It's an album I fell head over heels in love with when I was first really getting into music. I had it in constant rotation, and it really helped to shape my music taste. Hot Fuss is a 21st century post-punk new wave classic. The icy guitars, moody synths, and Brandon's OG goth baritone vocals, inspired by the likes of Ian Curtis and Paul Banks, creates the perfect sound palette for a nighttime drive through the city. This is a style the Killers would quickly abandon, but it's one they perfected. Hot Fuss has some of the best singles of the 2000s. Of course, Mr. Brightside is one of the most famous songs ever written, and for good reason. Jealousy is such a universal experience, and the imagery Brandon evokes brings that feeling to life in a timeless way. Coming Out of My Cage and I'm Doing Just Fine are some of the most iconic opening lines ever. Somebody told me it's a banger that has also endured in popularity, despite being the weakest of the singles, in my opinion. Smile Like You Mean It is a super underrated single with its swirling synths and biting sarcastic lyrics. Save some face, you know you've only got one. Love it, love it, love it. And I Can't Forget All These Things That I've Done, which is my favorite song ever written. The deep cuts here are just as amazing. Jenny Was a Friend of Mine and Midnight Show make up 2/3 of the Murder Trilogy. Both are amazing. The former is an amazing way to open the record, and the latter is written so well. On the surface, Midnight Show is a song about a night on the town with your girl, but if you listen beneath the surface, you see what dark horrors are really taking place. I Took My Baby's Breath Beneath the Chandelier of Stars and Atmosphere gives me chills every time I hear it. I'd also be remiss if I didn't mention the excellent On Top as a highlight. I wish they would embrace this goth new wave style again. Brandon's old vocals are just velvety and amazing. The darker synths and guitars here are just irreplaceable. Please. Hashtag bring back goth killers. Every song on this record is amazing. Hot Fuss is one of the best debut albums of all time, and there's a reason it has held on to its popularity nearly 20 years later. It's truly timeless. I've got this energy beneath my feet, like something underground's gonna come up and carry me. I've got this sentimental heart that beats. Coming in at number 1 is Sam's Town. Not only is it my favorite Killers album, but a top 10, perhaps even top 5 album of all time for me. This record brings us to a small town in America and uses it as a frame of reference to discuss the struggles and the darkness in the lives of everyday people. It often uses relationships as a focal point and revolves other issues around them. both romantic scene on songs like For Reasons Unknown and My List, and otherwise like on the track Uncle Johnny, where Brandon discusses a relative with a destructive drug problem. Drugs being a huge problem in small-town America. Someone who lives in a small town, I see it all the time, you know? You wander going through the town, see heroin needles just on the side of the road, and it's disappointing to see, and then knowing people with these issues, a song like Old Johnny hits hard. This River Is Wild discusses the fearful anxiety that comes with worrying about the endless possibilities of a chaotic future in a rapidly deteriorating world. This all contributes to the broader theme of the death of the American dream, how you become stuck in a small town filled with drugs and heartbreak where dreams go to die. This is masterfully written about in one line on the title track. I still remember Grandma Dixie's wake. I'd never really known anybody to die before. Red, white, and blue upon a birthday cake. My brother, he was born on the 4th of July. Amazing, because Dixie is a name for the old American South. He saw Dixie being used as a metaphor for the American dream. Die. It's then followed up by the irony of red, white, and blue on a birthday cake, kind of celebrating the idea of the American dream, despite the fact that he just watched it die. And it's brilliant musically. It's just as amazing. There is still light at the end of the tunnel on this record. On closing track, Why Do I Keep Counting, the Killers remind us to keep living despite the darkness of life, as Brandon exclaims that he can, in fact, make it down. This is also the most cohesive album the band has ever made. The inclusion of Interlude and Exitlude, bookending the album, gives it an even greater cohesion. The Killers trade out goth new wave for a stadium-sized classic rock influence. These songs are huge and anthemic, yet still filled with heart-wrenching emotion. The synths, guitar, drum, bass, and strings weave masterful melodies. From the moment this record starts, you're met with soaring synths and mind-blowing drum fills. Brandon Flowers gives a performance of a lifetime. It's one of the best performances on a record ever. He puts his whole heart and soul into this album. This album is also very personal for me. It got me through some dark times in my life and will always hold a very special place in my heart. This album has made me cry, and I've cried along to it many times, and it's still one I come back to in times of darkness and even in happy times. It's just an album that means so much to me, has done so much for me, has been a shoulder to cry on, and also a friend to celebrate with. It's something that, from the first time I heard it, has been just one of the most important records in my life. This River Is Wild has some of my favorite lyrics of all time. I feel like they've really become a part of me. I could talk about the little intricacies I love on Sam's Town all day. Things like the fuzzy guitar on the chorus of For Reasons Unknown, or the way Brandon says, "Superman" on Uncle Johnny. This album is the definition of perfect to me. It reminds us to keep living day by day, and it will always be a masterpiece. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. I had a blast with this. I love this band and love these ranking videos. Getting to spend this much time with an artist's whole body of work, then writing my thoughts about it, is just a blast. I'm really enjoying making these script-based videos, sitting down and writing and thinking about it. So your support just means the world to me. Make sure you leave a comment letting me know what you thought, and make sure to leave your ranking of the Killers records below. Go ahead and throw sawdust in there if you want. Again, thank you all for watching, and I'll see you all next time.